All right. Well, your second point, I think this one, you know, really speaks to home and, you know, something that at Veha'u we really have to narrow down. You say find a business that excites and energizes you. And, you know, if there's a quote actually that I read in a, there's a contemporary of mine that has a blog, and he was describing his time at a career fair. And he says, quote, "The recruiters were advertising the kinds of jobs that knock the soul out of people. The kinds of jobs that inhale our young, talented people and turn them into cogs." Now, what do you think about that?
I think it's true. I mean, there is moments in my, there have been always moments in my adult life when I have sort of gone back to thinking about and indeed embracing quotes like that, because I think it really is true that a lot of jobs, even today, despite promises to the contrary, a lot of jobs are just like that person said they were. Mm-hmm. And people need, every person graduating, I mean, the advice that I make about finding something that energizes and excites you is that an awful lot of the stuff that people come to campus, the recruiters come to campus for, probably not that all that exciting. Now, somebody might need to do it, and they will find a place for people. My point is that each of us is in charge of our own destiny. Each of us is in charge of our own happiness, our own soul, our own satisfaction. And we're kidding ourselves if we take a job and we're dazzled by a nice salary and a signing bonus and a company car, and after 6 months we realize we hate the job. At that point, it's time to leave. It's time to change. Now, maybe not after 6 months, because that looks bad on your CV. But at some point, we need to use an aviation term, since I spent my working life in the airline business, we need to disconnect the autopilot and think about our careers. I'll give you a good example of a place where I'm going to use a polite term now, where people, companies fib about what work is like. And that's, you know, everyone nowadays is talking about work-life balance. It has dawned on big companies that younger people are less inclined to put the number of hours in that the older generation did, right? But they are still slow to change. I mean, they may say, oh yeah, we offer great work-life balance. In reality, they do not. And if I could name names without actual names, I mean, big accounting firms are notorious for this. How do I know? My son was an accountant. When he was being recruited, the company that recruited him promised work-life balance. He got in the job, and it was not.
Yeah.
So, you know, my advice to people is that, you know, be very, very careful about these kinds of situations. Push back on the rhetoric and find out, for example, from people who work there now. Easy to find out. What's it really like? And my counsel about that, when I was talking to students about this earlier this week, you may not get it right the first time. And that's okay, because that's what point one, change, is about. You may not get it right the first time. So if you don't, be honest with yourself and say, this isn't working. Mm-hmm. And go find a place or a job where it is. And then if that one doesn't work, change again. Change and change and change again until you get it right.